Hello everyone, welcome to my channel India Gate. This is Nadine Sharma, and in this video we talk about the most important topic, that is computer organization and architecture in NIC Scientist B and Scientific Technical Assistant A. So here I providing 60 plus most important MCQs with related computer organization and architecture. So let's get started. Here first question: the main memory of a computer has 2 CM blocks, while the cache has 2 C blocks. If the cache uses the set associative mapping scheme with 2 blocks per set, then the block K of the main memory maps to the set. So there are 4 options. Option A, K mod M of a cache. Option B, K mod C of a cache. And option C, C mode 2C of the cache. And option D, K mode 2CM of the cache. So there are 4 options are given, and now we come to the solution of this question. So there is the representation of the set cache, and mapping representation is like 1, 2, and it goes till 2C minus 1 times, okay, as per the given questions. And here the mapping of the main memory is representing like 0, 1, 2, 3 till 2C minus 1 times, okay. Now we calculate the total number of the associative cache. So here we know very well the set in the set associative cache is equal to block in cache upon block in one set, okay. So according to given data, here block in cache is 2C and block in one set is equal to 2. So total number of set associative cache is equal to C. So therefore the block K of the main memory maps to the set K mod C of the cache. So here K mode C of the cache is your correct answer. Now come to the next question. Which of the following is our advantage of the virtual memory? So they are giving 4 options and 4 statements as well. Same. So here first statement, faster access to memory on an average. Option B, processes can be given protected address space. Option C, linker can assign addresses independent of the where the program will be loaded in physical memory. And option D, program larger than the physical memory size can be run. Yes, so here option D is your correct and main advantage of the main memory, virtual memory, okay. So virtual memory is based on the program larger than the physical memory size can be run. Yes, because so many times here virtual memory concepts is used when your program size is more than your physical memory. So we can use the physical memory space as a virtual. So it is calculated to be run the virtually concept into the memory, and your program is executed very sequentially manner. So due to of the virtual memory concepts, the program larger than the physical memory size can be also run, okay. So option D is your correct answer. Now come to the next question. Which of the following requires a device driver? So correct answer is option D. Yes, disk is most and one of the most requirement for the device driver. Okay, now come to the next question. More than one word are put in a one cache block to. So there are 4 options given. Option A, explore the temporal locality of reference in the program. Option B, explore the spatial locality of reference in the program. Option C, reduce the miss penalty. And option D, none of above. So here correct answer is more than one word are put in a one cache block to explore the spatial locality of reference in a program. So option B is your correct answer. Now come to the next question. Which of the following statement is false? So they are giving 4 statements. Statement A, virtual memory implements the translation of program's address space into the physical memory address space. Option B, virtual memory allow each program to exceed the size of the primary memory. Option C, virtual memory increase the degree of the multi-programming. And option D, virtual memory reduce the context switching overhead. So we found the false statement. So here option D is your false statement. Why? Because we know that virtual memory increase the context switching overhead. Okay, so here option D is incorrect, means false, and others are correct statement. Now come to the next question. Consider a system with two label caching. Access time of label 1 cache, label 2 cache, and main memory are 1 nanosecond, 10 nanosecond, and 500 nanosecond respectively. The hit rate of a label 1 and label 2 cache are 0.8 and 0.9 respectively. What is the average access time of the system ignoring the search time within the cache? So they are giving the four options. Option A, 13.0 nanosecond. Option B, 12.8 nanosecond. Option C, 12.6 nanosecond. And option D, 12.4 nanosecond. Now we come to the solution of this question. So as per the given data, here hit ratio and here time is already given. We just implemented the access time formula to calculate the correct answer. So here exit time formula is t1 into h1 plus 1 minus h1 into h2 into t2 plus 1 minus h1 into 1 minus h2 into tm times. Okay, so here we just put all the values as per the given data and just calculate the access time. So correct answer is your 12.6 nanosecond. Okay, now come to the next question. For inclusion to hold between the two cache level 1 and level 2 in the multi-level cache hierarchy, which of the following are necessary? So they are giving four statements. Statement 1, L1 must be a write-through cache, L2 must be write-through cache, and statement 3, the associativity of the L2 must be greater than L1, and the L2 cache must be at least as larger as the L1. Okay, so we easily say that here statement first and statement second are the necessary conditions for the multi-level cache. So we say that option B is your correct, first and second only. Now come to the next question. In an instruction execution pipeline, the earliest that the data TLB, that is translation look aside buffer, can be accessed is. So they are giving four options. Option A, before effective address calculation has started. Option B, during effective address calculation. Option C, after effective address calculation has completed. And option D, after data cache lookup has completed. So here correct answer is option B, during the effective address calculation. So here we use an instruction execution pipeline. The earliest data TLB can be accessed is during the effective address calculation. So option B is the correct answer. Now come to the next question. How many 32K into 1 RAM chip are needed to provide a memory capacity of 256 KB? So there are four options. Option A, 8. Option B, 32. Option C, 64, and option D, 128. Now come to the solution of this question. Here basically given basic RAM is 32K into 1. Okay, basic design, that is 250K into 8. Now number of RAM is equal to 256K into 8 upon 32K into 1. Okay, now we easily find the power of 2. Okay, so this is going to be power of 2 to power of 18, and 8 is equal to 2 to power of 3. Now here we also calculate 32k is also equal to 2 to power of 15, and here 1 is always equal to 2 to power of 0. Now we got here the number of RAM is equal to 64, so it required 8 parallel line. In each line, parallel line, 8 serial RAM chip are required. So here we say that option C is your correct answer. So option C is your correct answer. Now come to the next question. Consider a small two-way set associative cache memory consisting of 4 blocks. For choosing the block to be replaced, use the least recently used LRU scheme. The number of caches misses for the following sequence of block address is 8, 12, 0, 12, 8. Now they are giving 4 options, option A, 2, option B, 3, and option C, 4. And last option is your option D, 5. Now here all the data is given, like total number of block, that is 4. Where here we use the LRU scheme to solve this sequence, that is 8, 12, 0, 12, 8, and we found the number of catch miss. Okay. Now we come to the solution of this question. So this is very good question which is asking in the gate previous year question. So here we apply the LRU scheme on the given sequence. Okay. So we know very well total number of frame and total number of block is 4. Okay. So here when we inserting 8, so it is going to be missed. Okay. Now again we inserting 12, then it is also going to be missed. But here as we are inserting 0, it is also going to be miss, but it is replaced with 8 because here least recently used element, that is your 8. Okay, so 8 is replaced with 0. Okay, now again we using and inserting the element 12, so we get here 12 is already represent in the page frame, so this is going to be hit. Okay, not be miss. Okay, so no miss is found here, but when we inserting 8, we found that in the given previous frame, page frame, here no element 8 is found. So here 0 is replaced with 8 because 0 is recently used element. Okay, so we got total 1, 2, 3, 4 miss. So total number of miss in the catch is 4. Okay, so option C is your correct answer. Now come to the next question. In the KV set associative catch, the catch is divided into V set, each of which consists of K lines. The line of set are placed in sequence on after another. The line in set S are sequenced before the lines in the set S plus 1. The main memory block are numbered 0 onwards. The main memory block number J must be mapped to any one of the catch line from. So they are giving 4 options A, B, C, and D. Now basis of the given information, here option A is your perfect and correct answer because we require the main memory block number just map with any one of the catch lines from. So here we using J mod V into K to J mod V into K plus K minus 1 because here S is going to be S plus 1, so it is going to be in decrease K minus 1. So option A is your correct answer. Okay, now come to the next question. RAM chip has a capacity of 1024 word of 8 bits, each 1K into 8. The number of 2 into 4 decoders which enable line in needed to construct a 60K into 16 RAM from 1K into 8 RAM is. So here giving the 4 options, option A 4, option B 5, option C 6, and option D 7, and here correct answer is option B. Now why option B is correct, we come to the solution. Here we need 60K into 60 RAM from 1K into 8 RAM. Okay, this is giving the question. Okay, now number of chip is required, so here we very well easily to calculate the number of chip, that is your 60K into K into 60 upon 1K into 8. Now we get here 60 into 2, so we need 60 output of line. Okay, so if we need 60 output of 9 lines, so what the number of decodes you have to needed? You have to needed 5 number of decodes. How we come to the diagrammatic representation of the given decoder. So this is the decoder. So basis of this decoder, we easily define here including 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. If we use 5 number of decoders, so we easily create the 16 line of output. So here we say option B is correct, means we need 5 decoders. Okay, Next question, a four-way set associated to catch a memory unit with a capacity of 16 KB is built using a block size of 8 words. The word length is 32 bits. The size of the physical address space is 4 GB. The number of bits for a tag field is what? So we come to the solution for this question. And this is most probably asked question in many time of the examination. Now here, we calculate the number of word, okay, because here total number of word length is 32, so here total number of words is equal to 32 bits. Now we know very well it is divided into two parts, that is your block and this is your tag side. Now here tag is again block side is dependent and block option is divided into two set, that is set and word, okay. Now here we calculate word offset. How to calculate word offset? Because here 32 bits is already given, so here 55, 2 to power of 5 is equal to 32, okay. So here 5 is your word offset. Now here set offset is calculated as the total number of word is equal to 7, which is already given into the questions. Now we very well know about it. Here blocks is equal to 60 KB upon 8 words, means block size, okay. So it is going to be equal to 512 blocks. Now here we using the four-way set associative, so here 512 blocks is divided by 4, so we get here 128, that is your 128, and it is equal to 2 to power of 7, and here 7 is your what, that is your set offset, okay. Now we easily found the tag width. Yes, of course, if 32 minus this 2, we've calculated the tag width. Yes, yes, of course it is calculated. So 32 minus 7 minus 5, that is equal to 20 bits. So here tag is equal to 20 bits, okay. Now come to the next question. In designing a computer cache system, the cache block or cache line size is an important parameter. Which of the following statement is correct in this context? Okay, so they are giving four options. Option A, a smaller block size implies better partial locality. And option B, a smaller block size implies a smaller cache tag and hence a lower cache tag overhead. And option C, a smaller block size implies a larger cache tag and hence lower cache hit time. And option D, a smaller block size incur a lower cache miss penalty. So here option D is correct. Here option C is also going to be correct, but here we need only the correction in the statement, that is a smaller block size implies a larger cache tag and hence a higher cache hit time, okay. So here the cache hit time is going to be higher, not be lower, okay. So here we easily say that option D is your correct answer. A smaller block size incur a lower cache miss penalty. Now come to the next question. If the associative of a processor cache is doubled while keeping the capacity and block size unchanged, which of one of the following is guaranteed to be not affected? Okay, so here option A, width of the tag comparator. Option B, width of set index decoder. Option C, width of way selection multiplexer. And option D, width of the processor to main memory data bus. So here correct answer is option D, because here the width of the processor to the main memory data bus, it is constant, it is not going to be affected when we changing and when we double the processor cache while the keeping of the capacity and block size unchanged. So here option D is your correct answer. Now come to the next question. The total size of our address space in a virtual memory system is limited by. So here correct answer is option B, the available secondary storage. Okay, because here virtual memory system is limited by the basis of the secondary storage, that is your main memory storage. Okay, so option B is your correct answer. Now come to the next question. Comparing the time T1 taken for a single instruction on a pipeline CPU with time T2 taken on a non-pipelined but identical CPU. We can say that. So they are giving the four options. Option A, T1 less than equal to T2. Option B, T1 is greater than equal to T2. Option C, T1 is less than T2. And option D, T1 plus T2 is the time taken for one instruction fetch cycle. So here option B is correct, because when we comparing the time T1 taken in a single instruction on a pipeline CPU with the T2 taken a non-pipelined but identical CPU. So here the time of the single instruction on a pipeline of the CPU is greater than or maybe equal to time taken by the non-pipelined but identical CPU. Okay, so option B is your correct answer. Now come to the next question. The most appropriate match for the following pair. So this is one of the most questions which is asked in every exam, and here giving the questions, they are one pair which contains XYZ elements, and here another pair contains 1, 2, 3 elements. So in the first pair, indirect addressing, immediate addressing, auto decrement addressing listed, and in the second pair, loops, pointer and constant are listed. Now you know that loop we are using the increment or decrement functioning. Okay, so we easily say that here loop is goes to the auto decrement addressing, and in the case of the pointer we use the which type of the addressing, that is your indirect addressing. So it is goes to the your option and match to the x 2 2. Okay, now here last is, that is your constant, and constant is going to be matched with immediate addressing. Okay, so we say that here option C is your correct answer. X is matched to 2, y is 3, and z is equal matched to 1. Okay, now we come to the next question. Here next question is defined as, in serial data transmission, every byte of data is padded with a 0 in the beginning and 1 or more or 2 ones at the end of the byte because. So they are giving 4 options. So option A, receiver is to be synchronized for byte reception, and option B, receiver recovers lost zeros and ones from these padded bits, and option C, padded bits are used in parity computation, and option A, none of above. But here we use the in serial data transmission, every byte data is padded with 0, okay, with the beginning and 1 or 2 ones at the end of the byte, because we required and we receiver is to be synchronized for the byte reception. Okay, so option A is your correct answer. Okay, now we come to the next question. In 2 complement addition overflow, so they are giving 4 options. Option A is flagged whenever there is a carry from sign bit addition. Option B, cannot occur when a positive value is added to a negative value. And option C is flagged when the carries from sign bits and previous bit match, and option D, none of above. So here option B is your correct answer, because here 2 complements overflow is when it is occur when here the same time of the occur, but here it can't be occur when here positive values added to the negative value. Okay, so here option B is your correct answer with related this 2 complements addition. Okay, now come to the next question. The performance of a pipelined processor suffer if. So they are giving the 4 options. Option A, the pipeline stages have different delay. So this option A is come from your structural performance. Now come to the option B, the consecutive instructions are depending on the each other. So it is your come to from your control performance of the pipeline processors. Now here last 3, third option is say the pipeline stays share hardware resources. So it is your data performance. Okay, so we easily say that the performance of pipeline processes suffer if. So here option D is your correct, means all of above. Okay, so option D is your correct answer. Now come to the Next question. For a pipeline CPU with a single ALU, consider the following situation. So they are giving the three situations. Situation first, the J plus 1th instruction use the result of the jth instruction as an operands. Situation second, the execution of a conditional jump instruction, and third, the jth and J plus 1th instructions require the ALU at the same time. Okay, so here our question is asked, which of the above can cause a hazard? So here three situations, so these all three are cause hazards. Okay, so we say that option D is your correct, means all of. Now come to the next question. Match list 1 with list 2nd and select the correct answer using the code given below the list. Okay, so here list 1 contains line of code and list 2 contains corresponding addressing. Okay, so we come to the list of first element, that is A, and code is written like AI is equal to BJ. So here using the array, and we know very well array is used and based on the what, that is your indexing addressing. Okay, so we easily say that A is matched to 2, that is indexed addressing. Now come to the B, that is while, and here while loop we increment the value of A. So we easily say that the we list B is matched to the third, that is auto increment. Okay, so increment is also done in the while loop and loop type of the statement, so it is a correct match for B is going to be third. And last, that is C, that is int temp is equal to pointer x. So it is what type of the addressing? Here we are using the pointer, so pointer is used the indirect addressing. Okay, so here C is matched to 1. Okay, so this is the correct matching of the given list 1 to list 2. Okay, so we say that option C is your correct answer. Now come to the next question. A CPU has 24-bit instruction. A program start at address 300 in decimal. Which one of the following is a legal program counter all values in decimals? Okay, so here all the value is given in decimal. Now here giving the four option: option A 400, option B 500, option C 600, and option D 700. And correct answer is option C, that is 600. If you have any queries, so please comment me. Thank you for watching.